Hello everyone, once again I welcome all the viewers to this online class, especially for the class 10 students. Today we are going to continue with probability. We will start doing some exercise today, which is taken from class 10 textbook under the MBOSE syllabus. Let us recall the definition of probability for the occurrence of an event A. We have EA is equal to the number of favorable outcomes to an event A divided by the total number of all possible outcomes. In any random experiment, we will always have some possible outcomes. That is, the total number of all possible outcomes can never be zero. So in that case, this total number of all possible outcomes will always be greater than or equal to 1. But for any event, if you have defined an event, it can be that neither of the outcomes are favorable to that particular event. So in that case, we will have the number of favorable outcomes to that particular event to be 0. But the number of favorable outcomes, the least of it will be 0, right? Because it can either be there will be some favorable outcomes or no favorable outcomes, or all outcomes will be favorable. So in that case, this numerator will always be greater than or equal to 0. So this whole quantity here, this non-negative quantity divided by positive quantity will always be non-negative. So in that case, we will have the probability for the occurrence of any event A will always be greater than or equal to 0. And again, if you look here, the number of favorable outcomes to any event will always be less than the total number of all possible outcomes. That is easy to think, because anything will always be less than or equal to the total. So in that case, we will have this numerator to be always less than or equal to the denominator. So this whole quantity, which is PA, will always be less than or equal to 1. We will have this. We will see more of this when we do the exercise. But for now, what we have to note down is that the probability for the occurrence of any event is always between 0 and 1. Here, let's have a look at these extreme cases. That is when PA is equal to 0 and PA is equal to 1. First, let us look at this case when PA is equal to 1. What do we mean when we say that PA is equal to 1? In this case, the number of favorable outcomes to A is equal to the total number of all possible outcomes. So, in other words, we can say that any outcome will always favor to this event A. So in that case, any outcome will always favor, so this event A will always happen. So in this case, this event A is called a sure event. Then A is called a sure event, or we can also say a certain event. Let's have a look now when PA is equal to 0. What does it mean when PA is equal to 0? Number B. See? When PA is equal to 0, then from this relation again, when this quantity here is 0, then P of A bar will be 1. Then P of A bar will be 1. C. For any event A, when probability for the occurrence of that particular event is 1, then that event will surely happen. Then in this case also, P of not A is 1. So not A, using this case, not A will surely happen. So what we mean when we say that not A will surely happen, it means that A will never happen. To understand this, we may have an example where we can say that it cannot be possible that at the same time it will rain and it will not rain. So if it will not rain, so it will, that the rain will not happen at the same time, right? So it can either be rain or not rain at the same time. But here, not A will surely happen. So in that case, A will never happen. So in this case, A is called impossible event. Now we will move on to do some problems. The first one is, the question is like this. The probability that it will rain today is 0.87. Then find the probability that it will not rain today. See, first of all, here we will see the question. It is saying that the probability that it will rain today is 0.87. So here the probability is not 1, right? So we are not sure that it will rain today, or that it, yes, that will not rain, that will rain today. There is a chance that it will rain today, but we are not sure. So there's also a chance that it will not rain today, right? Because we are not sure that it will rain today. So we have to find that chance that it will not rain today. So solution, let that event that it will rain today, we call it to be EDD, event that it will rain today. Then from question it is given that probability that it will rain today, which we denote by PE, is given to be 0.87. We have to find the probability that it will not rain today. So not rain today, so we have to find probability that will not rain today, because E is the event that will rain, so not rain today will be E bar by our previous notation. So how do we find P of E bar? We will use again that relation which we have. This PA plus PA bar is 1. This relation holds for any event. So it will hold for this event E. So we will use using PE plus PE bar is equal to 1. We have PE is 0.87 plus PE bar is equal to 1. Then from here we will get PE bar, which is 1 minus 0.87. And if you simplify, you will get of this formula minus 0.87, so 39810. So it will be 0.13. This will be the probability that we will not rain today. Let us continue to do some more exercise. Let us have a look at this second question. which we will have to find the probability about the cards now. One card is drawn at random from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards. Find the probability that a card drawn is a black card, ace of hearts, a spade, either a red card or a king, neither a red card or a king. Before we do this problem, first of all, what we will do is we first see what is actually the deck of 52 cards. In a deck of 52 cards, because it's saying 52 cards, so there are 52 cards. So there are four suits: clubs, diamonds, hearts, and spades. There are 13 clubs. Clubs, you will go along this row: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 clubs, 13 diamonds, 13 hearts, and 13 spades. All the clubs and all the spades are black. All the diamonds and all the hearts are red. Where do we get the ace? We get the ace from this first column. See the ace, how many of them? 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are four A's. This ace here, this is the ace which is of the clubs. This is the ace which is of diamonds, ace of hearts, and ace of spades. So altogether there are four A's, two black A's, and two red A's. Similarly, if you go along this column, this second one here, these are all cards which are two. These cards have the number two which are written on them. So similarly to ace, these cards will have four of them, and then there are two black cards which are a two and two red cards which are a two. Similarly for 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we have these cards which are called jacks. So there are four of them, four jacks, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Two black jacks, this one and this one, and two red jacks. Similarly with queen and king. So if we say that how many black cards in a deck of 52 cards, so black cards you can get from clubs and from spades. There are 13 clubs and 13 spades, so together there are 13 plus 13, which is 26. So there are 26 black cards. Similarly, you can get red cards from here, diamonds and hearts. There are 26 red cards. So you can simply draw like this. You can simply draw like this because the clubs and the spades, they're all black. You can just write black like this. And the diamonds and hearts, they're all red. So you can simply draw this. I hope you will understand. Now, this question, it is saying from a deck of a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards, one card is drawn at random. Mean from all the 52 cards, they are very properly shuffled. So when you draw one card, so any one of the card is possible to be drawn, right? So in this case, there is a probability that any card will be drawn. So we have to find the probability that the one card drawn is a black card. So now we will do this, number A. Solution number A. Let the event of drawing a black card, we call it to be E again. Let E be the event of drawing a black card. See? When you draw a black card from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards, you will draw a black card only when you draw anyone from the clubs or from the spades. But when you draw any card from the diamonds or from the hearts, then they will all be red. So in this case, how many outcomes which will favor to this event of drawing a black card? So when you draw a black card, the outcome which will favor to this event will be when you draw any from the clubs or from the space. So how many of them? There are 13 from the clubs and 13 from the space. These are the only outcomes which will favor this event. So we have number of favorable outcomes will be 13 plus 13, which is equal to 26. 13 from the clubs and this other 13 which is from the spades. But when you draw again from a well shuffled deck, any card is possible to be drawn. So any card is possible to be drawn, so the total number of all possible outcomes will be 52. So we have the total number of possible outcomes is 52. So here we have these two, so we can use that definition. Therefore, PE, which is equal to the number of favorable outcomes, 2E, divided by the total number of all possible outcomes. We already have those two, so I'll just write down here, which is 26 by 52. We can further simplify this. We can go with 2 into 1, 2 into 3, 6 2 into 4, so 1 remain, 2 into 6, 12. So 13 into 1, 13 into 2. So it will be 1 by 2. So this is the probability of drawing a black card from a well shuffled deck of 52 cards. Now we will do this number B. What is the probability that the card drawn will be Ace of Hearts? Again, let the event to be of drawing the Ace of Hearts be E. So let E be the event of drawing an Ace of Hearts. So again, if you look from the 52 playing cards, you will draw Ace only if you draw any of these cards, right? But if you draw this card, this is an ace, but ace of the clubs. So this will not favor to this event because it's for drawing ace of hearts. But if you draw this one, it's also an ace, but of diamonds. If you draw this, this is an ace, so ace of hearts. So we have found one which favor this event. And this one is also an ace, but it's ace of spades. So this is not favorable to this event. And if you draw from all these, the rest of the cards, they are not favorable because these, all these, they are not ace. So the only favorable outcome which will favor this event of drawing ace of hearts is only when you draw this card, right? This one right here, which is red, which is an ace and which also of the hearts. So this is the only card which is ace of hearts. So in this case, the number of favorable outcomes is only 1. But again, because there are 52 cards, so any of them is also likely to be drawn. So that's why the total number is still 52. Then again, by definition of probability for the occurrence of event E, it is number of favorable outcomes to E divided by the total. So this is just 1 by 52. I hope you have understood this. Now we will do this number C, a spade. What is the probability that a card drawn will be a spade? Again, from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards, When you draw a card, the card that you will, that you draw will be a spade only if you draw any from these cards from here. These are the only spades, and there are 13 of them. So in the same way, because there are 13 of them, these are the only outcomes. When you draw either this or this, all from this row, these are the only outcomes which will favor this event. And how many of them? There are 13. So that's why the number of favorable outcomes, if we call E to be the event of drawing a spade, drawing a card which is a spade, this is number C. For number C, we call E to be the event of drawing a spade. So the number of favorable outcomes will be 13, because there are only 13 spades. And again here, because any card is likely to be drawn and there are 52 of them, that's why the total number of all possible outcomes will be 52. So again here, by definition, we will have this will be 13 by 52. And you can further simplify this. We can call this by 4. 4 into 3 is 2. Or 4 into 3 is 12. We carry 1. 4 into 1, 4, 5. So 13 into 1, 13 into 4. This is the probability of drawing a spade. Now, we will do only these two more relating to the cards. Now, number T, what is the probability that the card drawn at random is either a red card or a king? We will do this one, number D. So let that event of drawing a red card or a king be E. So number D, let E be the event of drawing a red card or a king. We will see which outcomes are favorable to this particular event. Now, you will get the outcomes to be favorable to this event only when you draw, because only when you draw a red card or a king. And a red card will get only from the diamonds or from the hearts. But if you draw this one also, which is black, but it is still a king, so it will still favor this event. Similarly with this one here. But not for this one, because this is not red, neither king. That's why this outcome of drawing this one will not favor that event. Similarly with all of these, and all of these. So the only outcomes which will favor this event of drawing either a red card or a king will be when you draw any from these and this one. And how many of them? There are 13 from this diamonds, 13 from this hearts, and the king, actually there are 4 kings, but this event of drawing this, the outcome of drawing this red card here is been counted when we say red card, so that's why we take this and this, so therefore there are 13 plus 13 and plus these two. So there will be how many favorable outcomes? There will be 13 from diamonds plus 13 from hearts and 2 more which are not red, but they are coming from the kings. So how many of them? 13, 13, 26, this will be 28. And same thing here, the total number of all possible outcomes will be 52. So in this case, the probability would be 28 by 52. We can go with 4, 4 to 7, 4 to 1, 4, 4 into 3. 3 is 12. So this is the probability of drawing either a red card or a king. Now we will do this one last problem, number E. This is number E. Here it is saying, what is the probability of drawing neither a red card nor a king? So let that event to be E, a drawing neither a red card or a king, not a king. The only outcomes that you can get to be favorable when you to this event of drawing neither a red card or a king is when you draw a card which is not a red card and which is not a king. So you can get that if you have this table, it will be easy for you. So you can get those cards which are not red and not king only when you draw any from these, right? From these cards till here and from this bottom till here. These are the only outcomes which will favor that event of drawing neither red nor king. How many of them there are from here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and from here 12 more. So the number of favorable outcomes will be 12 plus 12 will be 24. So same thing here, be 52 the total, and here will be 24 by 52. So again here we can go with 4, 4 into 6, and 4 into 1, 4 into 3. So it will be 6 by 30. I hope you have understood this. So for today we will stop here. We will see again next time. Thank you.